Thank you for joining me for this slow art experience. I'm going to guide you in a simple looking exercise that focuses on an object by an artist from Zia Pueblo in northern New Mexico that is in the collection of the St. Louis Art Museum. To begin, assume a comfortable position. If you'd like, close your eyes and just listen for a moment. Take in a deep breath through your nose. Now breathe out through your mouth. And again, take a deep breath in. And as you let it out, relax the muscles of your jaw and shoulders. Last time, breathe in and breathe out, emptying your lungs entirely. Now, open your eyes and let your breathing discover its own natural, unhurried pace. Allow your gaze to wander over each image of this object. As you look, notice the shape of the object, the colors, and finally, the painted designs that adorn the belly, shoulder, and neck of this pot. Which design elements are repeated? Which images are recognizable to you? Which ones are not? Let's take a closer look. Let's start by examining this creature. We see one large eye, a short, pointed beak, and two rounded feathers sprouting from its small head. Moving down its short neck, we see its bulbous body with streaks of white, a teardrop-shaped wing protruding from its back, and three long, rounded tail feathers. This is known as a Zia bird because variations of it are often found on pottery made by Zia Pueblo artists starting around the late 19th century. There are two on this vessel, which was made around 1930, that the artist painted to appear nearly identical. While these depictions are not meant to represent a particular bird, they are almost always accompanied by plant life. Now let's take a closer look at the bird's surroundings. Notice the flowers with reddish-colored petals that are very similar to each other in size and shape. The petals surround a white flower head filled with tiny dots. The flower's dark, thin stem curves downward and connects to a stalk with leaves near the bottom. Emerging from the same stalk between the flowers, there is a shoot with several lines radiating outwards near the top. There are several plants on this object with similar features, but each one has a unique posture, almost as if they are swaying in the breeze. Notice that these plants appear to grow out of the repeated points of the scalloped line that circles the vessel. This undulating design not only surrounds the entire object, creating a delineation of space, it also is reminiscent of the arroyos, or gullies that channel flash floods in the southwest. If you look closely, you will see that the artist has referenced this natural phenomenon with stylized swells of water contained in each curve. This object is known as an olla, which means pot in Spanish, and often refers to an earthenware jar with a short, narrow neck and a full, rounded body like this one. It was ideal for storing water and other liquids because its small opening helps prevent evaporation in the desert heat. Ollas were also used for cooking. The thin walls of the vessel allowed for changes in heating temperatures, while the shape helped retain moisture and food. Perhaps the most interesting connection to the undulating design that encircles the center of this vessel is that ollas were occasionally used for irrigation. They were buried between plants with only the neck exposed so that the roots would receive water that would slowly seep through the vessel's unglazed earthenware walls. Now, bring your focus back to your breathing. Thank yourself for taking the time to explore this work of art. Try to keep this feeling of curiosity and perhaps enjoy a little bit of nature as you go through your day. Thank you for joining me for this slow art experience.